So, in this tutorial, I'm going to give the final revision, and we will also run this program that we have written in the last tutorial. You can see that there are four functions that we have implemented. So, I will run it, and there are some errors in this program, and we will remove those errors in the program, and I will revise this add after function, which you can see here. We're going to revise this function because I think that there were a lot of confusions in this particular function. So we will revise it later on. So first of all, the first error that was in this program is that you can see that we have P is the pointer which is used for traversing. And it should point from one structure to the another. So we will have to assign P equals P next. So this was the first mistake in the program. We have not written this line, and this line is useful, and we will also have to edit this while loop. You can see that in this while loop, the condition says that P should not be equal to the next pointer of last. And the last next means the first structure. So this loop will run only when the pointer P is not pointing to the first structure. But you can see that in this line, we have assigned P to point to the first structure. So this while loop will never learn. It will not run because we have assigned P equals last next in this line, and here we are comparing the P with the last next, which is not true, as you can see here. So what we can do here is we can make this while loop as a do while loop. So we will make this while loop a do while loop, and the reason why we are doing this is because we will let the P pointer start from the first structure, and it will traverse through the whole structures, the whole nodes in our circular linked list, and at every iteration the P pointer will point to the next structure. So I will write here, after every iteration, P points to next node. And so in this way, we are incrementing, or you can say we are making P pointer point to the next element. So the main use of do while loop is that it will let this whole program run for the first time because the value of P is pointing to the first node, and then the P pointer will change after this line. So now our while loop will work, and it will evaluate, this condition will evaluate to be true, and it will traverse until and unless the P pointer reaches back to the first node. So this should be do while loop. So for traversing in a circular linked list, instead of using a while loop, we will use a do while loop. And the similar mistake is also here. We will have to make it do while loop. So these were the only mistakes in this program, and you will get to know why we are making it do while loop and why we are using this pointer P in a bit later. First of all, let's just run this program and see what will be the output. So now you can see the output here, which is 3, 6, and 4. So this is our linked list now, and you can see that this result is true because we have first added a node 4 in our linked list, so it is here. Then after 4 In the beginning of the linked list, we have inserted 3, and after 3, we have inserted the node 6. So you will have to remember that you should update the p pointer to point to the next, and you will have to write it after this check statement, because we are going to update this next pointer even if this condition evaluates to be false. So that's why this should be outside this if block. So in this way, we have implemented the circular linked list, and we have seen the output also. So I just want to revise the add after function again. So let's see at this add after function of how it actually works, and let's just revise again how we are using this p pointer and why we are using a p pointer here, and we will also revise this condition. So let's move on to the add after function. So in the add after function, we were giving these three arguments, which is the last pointer, the data of the node, and the item after which we want to insert our data. So let's suppose we will take a linked list, a circular linked list with data 1, and 4. So let's suppose this is our circular linked list, and we want to add node 3. We want to add this node 3 after the node 2. So we will use this add after function, and in this function we will pass the last pointer. The data is 3 in our case, so data is equals to 3, and item is the item after which we want to insert our node, so item is 2, so the value of item is equals to 2. So now we want to insert this node after this particular node which we are passing at the time of function call. So the first thing that we need to do is we will have to create a temporary node, and we will allocate this temporary node in the main memory using the malloc function. So we will allocate this node in the main memory using the malloc function. So this we have done. The next step is to find the appropriate place for this node so that we can fit this node at the appropriate position. So to reach the appropriate position, we will have to traverse through the linked list. So what we have done is we have created a pointer p. So we have created a struct node pointer p, and this pointer p, we have assigned this pointer p to point to the first element of our circular linked list. And we know that if we want to access the first element, we will just use the next pointer of the last. So last next will point to the first element. So what we have done is we have just assigned a pointer p that is pointing to our first node. And we know that the first node will be having some data. So p of data represents the data of the pointer where p is pointing to. So what we are going to do is we will have to find the appropriate place for this item to be inserted. And for that, we will have to check when the data of p will become equal to the item. So we will just use a do while loop to traverse through this linked list, and this pointer p will get updated after each iteration. So in the do while loop, we are going to update the p pointer like this. So after every iteration, this pointer p will get assigned to the next pointer. So after each iteration, we will check whether the data of the p pointer is equal to the item after which we wish to enter our temporary node. So let's see how the iteration will work. So in the first iteration, the data of p is equal to 1, which you can see here that this is 1. So when we will use an if condition, if p data equals equals item, then only we are going to allocate this temporary node. So if this condition is true, we are going to allocate this temporary node, and this if else condition is inside the do while loop. And in the do while loop, we are incrementing the value, or you can say the pointer p. So after each iteration, the pointer p is pointing to the next structure. So this if condition is used to check whether the data of the p is equal to the item or not, because we cannot insert this temporary node after we will have to find the particular position where we have to insert this. So whenever the data of this p pointer will evaluate to be 2 or to be equal to the item, we are going to create a temporary node, and then only we will create the links. So you can see that when p will come at this position after the second iteration, the data of p will be 2, and our item is also having the value 2. So at this position, we are going to allocate the temporary node using the malloc function. So this is the main use of the pointer p. So that's why we are using a pointer p. And this pointer p is pointing to the first element. So we will run it for the first time, and that's why we are using do while loop. So that it runs this whole code without checking. And after the first iteration, it will check whether the pointer p is not equal to the first structure. So this pointer p will come here, then again here, and after the third iteration, it will point to the first structure, which is last next. So when it will come to the first structure, this condition p not equal to last next will evaluate to be false, and the program will come out of this loop. So that's why we are using the do while loop. So two important steps to write this add after function. The first one is to create a pointer p to traverse through the linked list. The second step is to check whether the data of p is equal to the item where we wish to enter our temporary node. And the third step is, now you can create the links inside this if block. So now we have found that now we have found the appropriate place of this temporary node. So what we are going to do is, we will now p pointer is pointing to this two structure. Now we are going to create the links. So you can see here in this program also, we have first written the we have created a p pointer, and it is pointing to the first structure. Then we are using the do while loop here, and after each iteration, p is pointing to the next structure or the next node. And we have used an if else statement, and inside if this evaluates to be true, we have assigned a temporary pointer. and we have used the malloc function to allocate this temporary node, and then we have assigned the data to this temporary node. So the last step is to create the links, and this is an important step. So let's see how we will create links here. So now we have found the appropriate position. So now P is pointing to the structure after which we wish to insert our node. So what we need to do is we will have to assign the next of this temporary node point to the node after this P pointer. So you can see that P is pointing to this node, and we want to make the next of the temporary node point to the next of the P pointer. So the first step in creating link is that we will make the next pointer of this temporary node point to the next of P. So this is the next of P. So this is our first step, and remember that you can assign this pointer only inside this if block. You can see that this is inside the if block. So the next step that we're going to do is now we will assign the next pointer of the P structure. P is basically the particular structure after which we will insert this node. So we will make the next pointer of this P structure point to our temporary node. So we will make the next of P equals temp. So we have just revised this whole function again, and we have now it is simple and clear to you that why we are using the P pointer. We are using it for traversal and to reach the particular element, and after reaching the particular element only we are allocating our temporary node, and then only we are assigning the links, because if you are not going to iterate to the particular element, you will not be able to access the position. You can see that the position is accessed using the pointer P. So that's the main use of the do while loop. Do while loop is used for the traversal. So this is our do while loop, and there is an error in the program, and that was that we are not using the do while loop, we are using just while loop. So remember that you will have to use a do while loop. So that's all for this tutorial. Thanks for watching.